together. A big talking point with Mr. Joe Biden has been the handling of the COVID-19 pandemic, if that's what you want to refer to it as. And he released not too long ago what his plans are. And we're going to go through this together on the show and what he talks about specifically on his website. What is he going to do different when in comparison to Donald Trump? And we'll kind of recap, but we'll go through this along the way. COVID-19. This is Biden-Harris transition. So how are they going to handle this? The American people deserve an urgent, robust, and professional response to the growing public health and economic crisis caused by the Modelo virus outbreak. President-elect Biden believes that the federal government must act swiftly and aggressively to help protect and support our families, businesses, small businesses, first responders, and caregivers, essential to help us face this challenge. Those who are most vulnerable to health and economic impacts and our broader communities, not to blame others or bail out corporations. The Biden-Harris administration will always, this is in bold letters, this is what they say, listen to the science. Ensure public health decisions are informed by public health professionals. Promote trust, transparency, common purpose, and accountability in our government. Well, those terms are all oxymoronic in that last bit. But the hilarious thing about this and how leftists really approach this pandemic for the most part is that they act like there's the science. They assume that all science agrees with each other, which is anti-science, by the way. And they act as if every scientist agrees on how this should be handled. They don't. Now, that doesn't mean that they might not ostracize or attempt to ostracize those that have a different position as opposed to, I don't know, lock everything down, mask mandates and stuff like that. The people that are experts have the same credentials and so forth that disagree with those particular actions and executing those as a particular plan. Those guys, they may be talked bad about, but that doesn't mean they don't exist. But what it is that they're saying, let's see. So President-elect Biden and Vice President-elect Harris have a 7-point plan to beat COVID. Let's see what they're talking about. They want to ensure all Americans have access to regular, reliable, and free testing. They want to double the number of drive-through testing sites. Invest in next-generation testing, including at-home tests. That sounds freaky. An instant test so that we can scale up our testing capacity by orders of magnitude. Stand up a pandemic testing board like Roosevelt's war production board. It's how we produce tanks, planes, and supplies in record time. It's how we will produce and distribute tens of millions of tests. Like, remember, this is all with something with a survivability rate of 99%. Establish a U.S. public health. They always seem to look for, and that's what libertarians, the case that we've been making, is that they'd never look at something and say, okay, how can private individuals handle it? If there's an ongoing issue or a broad issue, they look at it to always as a means to be able to expand upon the government. We ain't even got to the bulk of the actual post, and this fool's already talking about establishing new administrations and programs and bureaucrats and what have you. And of course, that's always the excuse. Public safety, public health, caring about the common man and what have you. Next, fix personal productive equipment, PPE problems for good. President Joe Biden-elect is taking responsibility and giving states, cities, tribes, and territories the critical supplies they need. Full use of the Defense Production Act to ramp up production of masks, face shields, and PPE so that national supply of personal protective equipment exceeds demand and our stores and stockpiles, especially in hard hit areas, blah, blah, blah. If I'm not mistaken, and someone in the if someone in the chat could do this for me and verify that this is the same Korean Wartime Act that allowed the government to hijack factories. This was something that I believe Chuck Schumer, as well as Bernie Sanders, was advocating early on in the pandemic. I believe that it is the Defense Production Act. What is basically, it's a Korean Wartime Act. And what it does is it basically is fascism. What it allows to do, what it allows the government, the federal government to do, is completely hijack factories of private business owners to use them to make whatever it is that they want. It's absolute fascism. And this is the hilarious thing about the crackheads that voted for Biden and Harris, and that they will up and down call Donald Trump a fascist. They will up and call Donald Trump a fascist. Yet, when it comes to this pandemic, what they will advocate is fascism, right? Where they are essentially wanting to merge the corporate entity with the state, which you can argue that in a lot of cases already is, but this obviously is the cherry on top. Well, there is no disconnect. Everything in the state, nothing out. So it looks like some people in the chat said I was correct. So it is that. That's what I figured that it was. This is a very dangerous thing. That's a very dangerous thing in which it allows this federal government to basically hijack people's factories and use them for what they want to use them as. This is what kills me about the call Donald Trump a fascist all day long. But in the event that they can do it for public health, or they can do it for something like, I don't know, caring about the individuals, or the group, or rather, not the individuals. They don't care about the individuals, make no mistake. They care so much about the groups. And that's what they use to do these different things. Expand upon the government, intrude on people's rights. That's what they want to do. They crap on Trump. They call him a fascist. And y'all have voted in someone that wants to advocate, that is advocating literal fascism as it pertains to this. This is why voting, when I think it's a mistake that people use the term voting rights. First of all, there's no right to vote. That's not actually a right, right? And by right, I'm meaning by the literal sense, as it's something that you have. It cannot be stripped away from you. It can only be intruded upon. You don't got a damn right to vote to rule for people that rule over other individuals. You have no such right. Even if we assume that it was a right, though, that's an absolute mistake. Because people get to vote. We can talk all day long about how this is supposed to be a republic. Doesn't change the fact that these are elected democratically. And y'all, who are literally stupid people, right? People that will talk about this even more so in the show. I have a prime example of this, of people not knowing what they're voting for. They don't understand the policies that they advocate because it's rhetoric that is peddled by way of blue check marks, media, and they just gobble it up. This is why someone can advocate for literal fascism and get away with it while claiming that the other person is a fascist. So they said, so we got to get rid of the fascist. Donald Trump, he's a fascist, 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 fascist. And here we are, where you got someone wanting to use the Defense Protection Act, which allows them to hijack factories and use them for whatever reason that they want to use them as, which is literal fascism. Let's see what else he has to say. Provide clear, consistent, evidence-based guidance for how communities should navigate the pandemic and the resources of a school, small business, and make it through. Yeah, yeah. Social distancing is not a light switch. It is a dial. Seems to be a light switch in terms of when y'all say that it's a thing that needs to be done. Because you certainly don't apply that when it comes to riots and protesting. President-elect will direct CDC to provide specific evidence-based guidance for how to turn dial up or down relative to the level of risk and degree of viral spread in the community, including when to open or close certain businesses. Like, basically, first of all, this is already effectively being done already, nonetheless, but it just sounds good when they get to buttering up and say, well, I will instruct them to guide you and all this. This is already happening for the most part. CDC's already doing this. establish a renewable fund for state and local governments to help prevent budget shortfalls, which may cause states to face steep cuts to teachers and first responders. I'm perfectly fine with this one right here. Cut as many public school teachers as you'd like. That's a positive thing. Call on Congress to pass an emergency package to ensure schools have the additional resources. Disagree. Provide a restart package that helps small business cover the cost of operating safely, including, like things like plexiglass and PPE. How about this, Joe Biden? How about we just don't do that? How about we just allow private businesses to be private businesses and they can decide for themselves how they want to open up? And let the consumers decide if that's something that's a risk that they want to take, depending on what sort of policies and procedures that they're going through. How about that? This isn't about saving lives or saving. Well, this is what they say. This isn't about politics. It's about saving lives. Saving lives works as well. Plan for the effective, equitable distribution of treatments and vaccines, because development isn't enough if they aren't effectively distributed. Joe, this is something that Trump was already talking about. Invest $25 billion in a vaccine manufacturing and distribution plan, okay, that will guarantee it gets to every American cost free. So free vaccines. I'm not taking that shit. And you see, unlike a lot of people like calling me names, that doesn't really work for me. You have no power here. So if someone wants to sit up and scream I'm anti-science or anti-vax, I don't care. Doesn't mean anything. I'm not taking that damn vaccine. Not taking it. I'm not taking a vaccine for something that has a 99% survival rate. And that is just another respiratory illness, viral illness, right? Something that I can get and I can pass. Like, as in, like, not pass to another person. That can happen as well. But as in, like, I can be fine after the fact. No. No, absolutely not. And certainly I'm not for a vaccine that just came out. Right? You find out that the thing is I know modern science is such an awesome thing, but I don't think y'all have done the proper random controlled trials. Let's say that to push out a vaccine for a virus y'all just found out about, supposedly. I'm not taking a vaccine. That's not anything that I'm injecting in my body. There's other probably things that I could inject in my body that may be not the best for me. I'm okay with that. Vaccine for a virus that y'all just found out about, I'm a pass on that. It's not happening. But Mr. Joe Biden wants to spend taxpayer dollars, of course, to guarantee that it's free for whatever reason. Ensure that politics plays no role in determining the safety and efficacy of any vaccine. The following three principles will guide the Biden-Harris administration. Put scientists in charge of all decisions on safety and efficiency. Absolute mistake. Publicly release clinical data for any vaccine the FDA approves, and authorize career staff to write a written report for public review and permit them to appear before Congress and speak publicly uncensored. These people, and this is why guys like Joe Biden, as well as the people that support Joe Biden, are economically illiterate. Because they think like economics is a thing that you want to talk about light switches and stuff. They think the economy is a light switch, right? And that you can put all of the economic problems, which are some of these are economic problems, in the hands of a bureaucrats as well as scientists. Imagine that. We wait on and the scientists are in charge of all of the safety requirements that everybody, of course, must follow. That's insane. A lot of scientists are economically illiterate as well. So, of course, saying shut it down is something that they can say. This is why Fauci and all of those types of guys can say that so easily. Trust the science and shut it all down. We're going to need to go into a second lockdown. That's something that scientists can do because they don't understand the ramifications. That's not for them to understand as well. There's not a lot. There's some that have economic backgrounds. I believe Jay Bhattacharya of Stanford University is one who have been talking about the dangers of the lockdown and stuff. And there are some that have economic understanding that are also scientists, doctors, and what have you. A lot of them don't. So this is why it's so easy for them to be like, yeah, shut it down, because they don't understand the ramifications. They don't even think that that's a thing. It's like, well, we advise in our scientific expertise, of course, that you just shut it down. They can just say something like that, and it's just so easy. Ensure everyone, not just the wealthy and well-connected in America, receives the protection and care they deserve. It's a whole lot of vague stuff. And consumers are not price gouged. That's not a thing. No such thing as price gouging. Or rather, it's not a bad thing as you like to think. It's like the whole water, like the whole upping the price on water bottles in the event that there's a hurricane or something going down, or gasoline making it go much higher. Again, they don't understand how prices work because they're economically illiterate. So if someone is charging, instead of the bottle of water was $5, now it becomes $15. What they look at it, well, you're price gouging. And they look at that and they equate that as a negative thing, which is not, right? You want to ensure that more people can get access to it and don't hoard it. That's what a price is for. Right? And again, this is all economically illiteracy. This is the mistake that plenty of obviously this government has, but you've seen more socialistic governments such as the USSR, and they historically had as well. This is how you get over just shortages of certain products and goods, because you want to try to dictate the price of something as opposed to allowing the market to figure it out. Protect older Americans and other at high risk. President-elect Biden understands that older Americans and others at high risk are most vulnerable to COVID-19. Establish a COVID-19 racial and ethnic disparities task force. To provide recommendations and oversight on disparities in the like, this is unbelievable, man. Like, how this crazy emphasis on disparity and race and types of people, and how even when it comes to the science thing, how people focus so much on it when it comes to decision making, because they look at all disparity as a negative thing. Or a thing that just can't happen organically, right? There can't be a reason that this particular ethnic group be impacted by this more often, unless there's some sort of wrongdoing, of course. God forbid that those differences just be differences, and they can be accounted for in other aspects as opposed to just pointing to the fact that there's some wrongdoing. At the end of this health crisis, it will transition to a permanent infectious disease racial disparities task force. God damn, man. These motherfuckers. So another government task force, if you will, that infectious disease racial disparities. Like, y'all still think this has anything to do with science? You're on crack. This is a whole lot of nothing here. Rebuild and expand defenses to predict, prevent, and mitigate pandemic threats, including those coming from China. Oh, interesting. Thought that was racist. Immediately restore the White House National Security Council Directorate for Global Health and Security. Man, these guys just make up damn administrations. And biodefense. immediately restore our relationship with the World Health Organization. While not perfect, it is essential coordinating a global response during the pandemic. No, it's not. Relaunch and strengthen U.S. agency and international development. This guy is like, relaunch this, create this task force. Like, you want to talk about expanding upon the government. Expand the number of CDC's deployed disease detectives. So we have eyes and ears on the ground, including rebuilding the office in Beijing. Interesting. Implement mask mandates nationwide. See, of course, that's where you long lost me there. By working with government and mayors and by asking the American people to do what they do best, step up in a time of crisis. Well, if you're mandating it, you're not asking anybody shit. See, this is what gets me about people who mask their authoritarianism in like humanitarianism, where they make it seem as if there's something like you doing in a positive thing while they are basically holding a gun to your head. Right? It's like, oh, I have to hold this gun to your head, or you have to do what I want you to do. Experts agree that tens of thousands of lives can be saved if Americans wear a mask. And it's always about the experts, and there's no true evidence still that speaks to this case, by the way. Like I've mentioned before, the evidence actually, if anything, spoke to the contrary prior to April. And then all of a sudden the pandemic hits, and now all of a sudden science just unanimously agrees that masks are effective in preventing the spread of a particular virus, which, again, that was never the case. That was never the assumed consensus, which is why we never walked around life in a mask anyway. They were only worn by professionals in particular periods of time. And they were protected periods of time, and they understood definitely when doctors and surgeons would wear them. Like, there was an instance where they would wear them. They weren't wearing them. The nurses weren't wearing them up front. Right. They didn't just have them just to be having them on. Now they may, but not then. Then all of a sudden April hits, and now all of a sudden the science all agrees that the mask is so effective. Though, as we've pointed out before, you can go look at my video on this, talking about how effective mask mandates have been, where you can go throughout certain periods of different parts of the world. Let's say that. Throughout certain periods of time, and you can see that they're not all the same. It's not a unanimous thing where they implemented a mask mandate and the number of cases or deaths just changed because of that. No, in a lot of cases, they went up. Implement mask mandates nationwide is what he says. Every American, experts agree, blah, blah, blah. President-elect will continue to call on every American to wear a mask when they are around people. Outside the house, every governor to make that mandatory in their state. Local authorities to also make it mandatory. Just authoritarianism all the way around. And I don't want any, considering where we're at with this pandemic, right? No leftist, no progressive gets to say it's just a mask. You don't get to do that, right? You said that shit back in April, May, and we are, what, November. Right. The damn consoles are about to come out. It's been so damn long. Like, we're all cyberpunk is around the corner. That's how long that it's been a thing. These mask mandates, forcing people to wear masks as well as lockdowns. Right. Don't give me that crap. It's just a mask. You don't get to say that anymore. You have locked. You've put restrictions on people for, I don't know, 9 months, 8, 9 months. You don't get to do that. Say it's just a mask. And this is what I told y'all. I told y'all back in March, April, May. I got the video receipts, and people would say, well, if you want the country to reopen, you got to have the mask. And then you got both. You got mask mandates and you got lockdowns. Shut up. You don't get to say that. And we knew that was going to happen, but you're stupid enough to trust government. That they was just gonna, there's no such thing as a temporary government program. So if they wanted to go all in on a mandate, they was gonna go all in, and they were gonna extend it for a long period of time. There was no such thing as 15 days to slow the spread. I was laughing at that idea that you thought that was all that they were going to do. Like, well, just to cut our losses after 15 days, you idiot. So what you got? You got Mads, like, again, like I said in my last video, insert exhibit Pimp My Ride meme. Yo, dog, we heard that you like mask and lockdowns. So we put a mask on your lockdown. So now you got mask and lockdown. You got both. There was never any instance of, well, if you can just wear the mask, we can reopen. That was never on the table. That was never an option. So basically, this is his plan. It's all a bunch of authoritarianism, expansion of government in the name of humanitarianism and caring for their people. This is what y'all voted in.